Hello friends, I am Mr.S.R.Paryani, working as Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical, Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Today, I am discussing the topic gravity die casting. Learning outcome. At the end of this session, students will be able to understand gravity die casting, which is also called as permanent mold casting. What are the contents we will cover in this session? First, we will have an introduction and we will have the little bit information about die casting machine and what do we mean by gravity die casting, what are the advantages compared to sand molding and limitations, and then finally the applications. First, introduction. Die casting process, first of all, has an advantage. The main drawback of sand molding process is a mold needs to prepare for each casting produce, and the specialty of die casting process, which is also called a specialized casting process, a metallic mold is used to prepare sand mold with which larger number of castings are made. The metallic mold is also called as a die. So these are the basic main advantage of die casting compared to mold. Here we don't need to prepare mold again and again, and there we need to prepare the mold generally for the castings. Generally the mold material employed is metal or any alloy, and the die casting is classified into two types basically. First one is called gravity die casting, which we will be studying in this session, which is also called as permanent molding. And second is called pressure die casting, which we will be studying in future lecture. And pressure die casting, which is further classified into cold chamber pressure die casting and hot chamber pressure die casting. Unlike gravity die casting, in pressure die casting, the molten metal is forced into permanent mold, which is also called as a die cavity, under pressure. The pressure varies from 20 to 2000 kgf per square centimeter and is maintained till solidification stage is reached. The pressure is generally obtained by compressed air or hydraulically. So this is initial a basic difference between gravity die casting and pressure die casting, but we will study now. Die casting machines perform the following functions: holding the two die halves firmly together, closing the die, injecting molten metal into die, opening the die, ejecting the casting out of the die. These are some of the basic steps which are performed with the help of die casting machine. Now we will come to the gravity die casting, our main topic. The casting is called gravity die casting because molten metal is poured into mold under gravity only. Here no external force is applied to the liquid metal into the mold cavity. The casting is also called permanent mold casting because it uses the mold which is permanent, that is the mold can be used as many of times before it is discarded or rebuilt. Now we'll come to see the figure here. Now we will see gravity die casting, which is also called permanent mold casting. This is hydraulic operated cylinder which is open and close the mold. This is movable mold section and this stationary mold section. So with the help of this cylinder, which we can here close the mold and spray, with the help of nozzle we can spray, and mold is preheated and closed. See, mold is preheated and then closed. Now the force is applied here. So core, if it is all required, is placed. These are the cavities. With the help of this pressure, cores, if you are inserted, and mold is closed. This second step we can say. Now see, this is called gravity. As I told you, the metal is poured in the mold with the help of gravity. It fills the mold cavity with the help of gravity. So now we'll see, there is no some external forces required. Just this is the stationary part of the mold, this is moving part with the help of force, this is closed, and finally the molten metal is poured, and molten metal solidifies itself in the mold Now we'll come to the point. Permanent mold castings are made. How permanent mold castings are made? Permanent mold castings are made with the help of grey cast iron into two halves, having the high resistance to thermal shocks, alloy steels. Why? For very high temperature and withstanding surface erosion or non-ferrous alloys. Inner surface of molds are closed first and refractory and with the lamp black or core oil. This is done in order to reduce the chilling effect. Chilling effect in compared to sand molding in die casting is more because mold itself is made up of metal or alloys. So chilling effect on the cast metal and facilitate the removal of casting and to prevent the adherence of molten metal into the mold. So we are applying refractory and then lamp black or core oil into the mold. Pouring cup, risers, gates, sprue are present in the mold. Now, what are the advantages compared to sand casting? Here, in case we in die casting, we can have a very closer dimensional tolerances because mold itself is made of metal and easily we can achieve the same. Second, smoother surface and better appearance can be obtained. Third, fine grained metal surface because of chilling effect. As I told you, chilling effect is more compared to sand casting. Mass production is more economical because mold itself is made of metal or alloy. Low shrinkage and gas porosity because porosity is less or gas shrinkage, there is problems are less associated with the metal casting compared to the sand mold. Now you think whether toys, small baby toys, can be produced with this process. Now coming to the limitations. The first and foremost big limitation associated with this process is permanent mold costs are more is more compared to the sand mold. Here, as it is metal and some setup is required, so the costing is more compared to the sand mold. And the second, basically, it is suited for small or medium sized non-ferrous castings only. And the third, several defects such as stress and surface hardening may be produced due to surface chilling effect. As I told you in previous slide also, the chilling effect is more compared to the sand because the mold itself is made of metal parts, alloys parts. So here in this process, in die casting, the chilling effect is more, so the several defects like stress and surface hardening may be produced due to surface chilling effects. Since the gating system is cut in the mold halves, once machined, it cannot be changed. Now, as a gating system, as it is flowing, metal is flowed through the gravity and it is in the, it is called permanent mold also. So the once the gating system is cut, so it cannot be, it can be repaired, but it costs, once again, it generally costs heavy or one many times it needs to, that mold itself needs to be discarded. So it costs more or generally it is not economical in that case. The extreme high temperature of the molten metal make this metal unsuitable for steel casting. Now coming to the application part, the basic application or basically these processes applied for carburetor bodies. Of the automobiles, refrigeration castings, oil pump bodies, connecting rods and automotive pistons are made of from this process, typewriter segments, etc. Now what is basically throughout this session, what we have understand is the basically the mold itself has a gating system in the casting, in the mold itself, from which molten metal is poured. Then once it is made, so there are the thorough design consideration needs to be made because we cannot modify again and again. So generally it is suited for mass production system. It is not suited generally for prototype or small production system. Basically this is, and it is also, as it is a gravity die casting, it is also with the help of gravity only the metal pours. in the next session, what we'll be studying is what are the advantages or disadvantages compared with the help of pressure die casting of this process. So this process is many times suited for small to medium size castings only, and because of chilling effects we need to take care many things in this case. Now the references which we have taken is from YouTube, and PL Jain, Principle of Foundry Technology, and the NPTEL notes. Thank you.